with the wind. So the Grundfos 170 pump that we've got in the well there is supposed to push up to a maximum head of about 70 meters if supplied with 900 watts of power, 0.9 kilowatts. So I figured that these two panels, as they were provided by the company, gives around 570 to 600 watts of power. So I'm going to be adding a third panel, which fortunately we had lying around, onto the string in series. It's going to keep the, it's going to up the voltage and keep the current at 8 amps, but it's going to up the wattage. I'm going to alter this now and just add some beams so we can get a third panel up here. It's not much to do, but I think that'll be nice, and then we can actually see how this works. I don't have uni struts to mount these, and I can't find them. I'm going with suggestions, and that is to hook the screw mounts of the panels that got little holes here, 140 millimeters from the end. They work like picture hooks, so once the panel is in there, it sits on the screw and just kind of keeps it from sliding down while I mount the rest of the panel. So I'm putting these in intervals on both sides. Then I get the panel on and it slides in and it sits. And then I use wire ties that I make myself, and I tie the wire to these beams and to the top, and they will sit. These won't go anywhere. I've got the screw mounts in there like I showed you. I've got the wire ties in there. And tomorrow morning I can hook up the power and we can tidy up the cables, and then we can give it a shot and see what happens. But it's time to pack up and call it a day. So I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, so I actually wanted to do this test yesterday, show you how this works, but kind of glad we're doing it today. It's hazy, so it's a nice test for the panels. So what we've got here, as you remember, is the well, the choke valve, so that we can control the output at the 1,000+ ponies that those panels are delivering here. This thing can push 1.5 cubes an hour, which is too much. A stop valve will work better here. So these are kind of hard to control and know how much is going through. But I think I've got it about 20% there. Then I've got a second valve here, just in case I want to extract water directly for analysis or use it close by. And then I've got the valve up here that chokes down
the flow to the top of the eel. This is closed. If I open this, all the water will just run back down the eel, and this one is open. So turn this on. And we should have water within a second or two. And there it is. So that is the rate that I've got it choked down to. And this is now pumping at 9:30 a.m. It's October, so the sun is already very high, but it's working well. Now these panels are all wired in series, so their voltages are added together, but their amperage, their currents stay the same. So the, what is this, 8.8 amps, it remains 8.8 amps in series, but the voltages are added together, which keeps the current low, but the voltage is higher. And this works better with MPPT controllers, which is built into the borehole pump, this one in this case. Some of them have them externally or otherwise in the control boxes, but it works well for this, and especially since there is no shading issues, because with panels in series, shading is a problem. If shade falls into one panel, the whole string kind of drops down. So that is why this is in series. Parallel doesn't really make sense for this. In parallel, the voltages stay the same, but your amperage goes up. It means you have lower voltages. In the case of these panels, it would be 46, so they would remain at 46 volt, even though there's many of them in parallel. But the current goes up. So for something like this pump, which runs at 1000 watts now, having the panels in parallel would not make sense. It would be a lower voltage and a lot of amperage, a lot of current. So it's easier to deal with lower current, get to the 1000 watts with higher voltage, and that's why series makes sense. So happy with this, going to leave it as such, and give us a shout down there in the comments. I like to hear suggestions and comments and everything, so it's also good. And thank you very much for everyone that subscribed. You guys are heroes. We've got 204 subscribers at the time I'm recording this, so everyone that's in that 204, thank you very much. It's really awesome. Appreciate it. You make this happen. We'll see you next time. Cheers.